With 3 decades of experience of printing and embroidery, Acorn Printing have a client base including many household names and have even supplied t-shirts for the President of the United States. As the official teamwear supplier for BOSRA, you can order from our current range at t-shirtuk.com. Good morning, race fans. Welcome to BOSRA Race Roundup. We're here today for round 8 of the BOSRA MSA Skip Barber Championship. Summit Point Raceway today, and the time of day of the late afternoon from the iRacing update, so that's been enabled. Today we'll also see a change to the format of Race Roundup. We're skipping from highlights to full race coverage. Now, this is mainly down to time constraints and a lot of other projects going on in the background, so sadly I haven't got time to do that at the moment. Hopefully we will bring that back in the future, you never know, so we will continue with the commentary over the qualifying session and the results. So with that out of the way then, let's move on to the qualifying session here at Summit Point. It was Sobrand who took pole for Team Clockwork. He was ahead of the Bear brothers, Tony and Barry. Ben Hackerson's in 4th, ahead of Simon Underhill and Van Delden in 6th. Galenicki's in 7th for Motorsport Auctions, ahead of Alan McCain and Neil Bamber, Ricky Green in 10th. Simon Jackson started in 11th, ahead of Ryan Walker and Russell Barnes, with Chris Buttrell in 14th. Daniel Honeysmith, one of our newer racers for Acorn Printing, in 15th, and David Rowan for Bentley Boys in 16th. 23 drivers with us today, so it's Martin Brandon 17th, ahead of Jan Molesberg for Bone Solutions, David Waldock 19th, Francis Winnell in 20th, Dan Ford in 21st for Bentley Boys, followed by Sean Burnside for XL Designs, and Jonathan Beresford, a driver this week, not setting the time in qualifying. Fastest lap of the qualifying session was Sobrand, a 120.902. We are going to jump on board with him now and take a tour around here at Summit Point Raceway. If you're looking to upgrade your racing experience, then head over to Bowden Solutions. They offer the first and only bolt-on load cell brake mod for Thrustmaster pedals, and the TX G27 adapter allows you to use your Logitech pedals with a Thrustmaster wheel. See the link below for more information. After round 7, Sobrand 6 just 12 points behind Antonades in the championship, and you will have noticed in qualifying, no Antonades this week, so that will give Sobrand every opportunity to try and close that gap down and take the lead in the driver's standings. Starting his fastest lap of the qualifying session, this was lap number 14, so you can see his previous lap, a 1 minute 20.770. Coming into turn number 1 now, this is the 180 degree right-hander, nice and smooth through there, not using too much of the rumble strip, bouncing the car around. Now foot planted to the floor, coming up to turn number 3. This is the left-hander, the sweeping left-hander. This is a bit of a blind entrance into here, so keep it nice and tight in. You can run wide on the exit of the corner. Try to keep two wheels on the track though, so you don't pick up a penalty through there. Now coming down towards the twisty section of the course, turns 4 and 5 up first. Hard on the brakes going into turn 5. This opens up then into turn number 6 and 7. Another 180 degree right-hander. You can start getting the power down around halfway through here, so about now, get it down, keep it nice and tight once again. Now looking for a good exit line into turn number 8 and up towards turn number 9. See so many cars go off here, the oversteer and understeer playing a part there. Now foot once again planted. Now we come down the back straight towards the final corner and the pit entrance on the right hand side. So under the bridge we go, there's the pit entrance and another corner that's slightly blind. Keep it on the rumble strip here, and again plenty of space to run wide on the way out of here. That is it here at Summit Point Raceway. We're now back on the start finish straight. So Brand coming down towards the start finish line. You see there on the time screen, a 1 minute 29.02. The Synology DS216 Play is a 2-bay NAS featuring 4K video transcoding and powerful processing capabilities. Complement yours with Seagate NAS hard drives for the perfect high capacity storage solution. See the video description for more details. Motorsport auctions are the global marketplace to buy and sell used racing rally cars, parts, transporters and associated equipment. With competitive pricing on all types of membership, list your items now at motorsportauctions.com. Moving on to our race results, it was Sobrandy took the win ahead of Simon Underhill. Van Delden in third ahead of Ben Hackerson in fourth. That win for Sobrand will help him catch Antonades in the overall driver standings. So it was Galenicki in fifth ahead of Simon Jackson and Alan McCain. Chris Buttrell in eighth ahead of Barry Bird and Darren Ford in tenth. Jan Mosver in 11th for Bowden Solutions ahead of Russell Barnes and Ricky Green. Rowland in 14th, Honey Smith 15th and in 16th Ryan Walker. Martin Brannan in 17th, ahead of Jonathan Beresford and Francis Winnell. David Waldock 10 laps behind, Neil Bambo a bad race for him, 21 laps down. Tony Bird and Sean Burnside finished 22nd and 23rd. Moving on over now to the overall driver standings, Sobrand leapfrogs Antonades into the lead, 15 points separate them. Simon Underhill moves up 2, but he's 49 points behind Antonades now. Simon Jackson 4th. Neil Bambers down 2 into 5th, ahead of Van Delden and Ben Hackerson. Phil Gregory in 8th, ahead of Darren Ford. Martin Guernicke leading the way for Motorsport Auctions, ahead of his teammate Chris Buttrell. Then it's the Baird brothers for Tech Speed Racing. Waldock's 14th, Alan McCain 15th, and Matt Tillet in 16th for Seagate and Synology. Piercy for XL Designs in 17th, ahead of Russell Barnes, and then it is the Bowden Solutions pair of Moesva and Green for 19th and 20th. Robson's 21st, ahead of David Rowland. He's moved up 5 places this week into 22nd. He's ahead of Ian Thorne and Ryan Walker. Brandon's 25th, ahead of Scott Malcolm and Andrew Whitehead. Larson, we haven't seen him since Donington Park in 28th. Jonathan Beresford, 29th. Winnie Smith's got some points on the board for Acorn Printing, 7 points in total for him. He's ahead of Francis Winnell, and 32nd is Sean Burnside. Switching now to the team standings, it is XL Designs who still lead, but Team Clockwork, Leapfrog, Seagate and Synology into second. They're 48 points behind the leaders, with Seagate and Synology 53 points behind XL Designs. Bentley Boys Racing in fourth, with Bowden Solutions moving up a place ahead of Motorsport Auctions into fifth. Tech Speed Racing are in seventh, and Acorn Printing, they are 159 points behind the leaders now, in eighth. Next week we're off to round 9 of the championship, that's at Suzuka GP, and we hope you'll join us for that, and also we hope you've enjoyed the new look race roundup. But for now that is it from us, so thank you ever so much for watching and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.